Hi friends, welcome back to Sharon Zoology. See, in this video lecturing, I'm going to explain about human spermatogenesis. So you know what is spermatogenesis? Spermatogenesis means formation of sperm. Spermatogenesis, formation of sperm or spermatozoa, called as spermatogenesis. So formation of spermatozoa or sperm. Formation of spermatozoa or sperm called as spermatogenesis. And in human male, this gametogenesis or this spermatozoa formation, it begins at puberty. This process of spermatogenesis begins at puberty. Unlike female gametogenesis, the male gametogenesis or spermatogenesis begins at puberty. Then the entire process of spermatogenesis, the whole stages of spermatogenesis, the entire process of spermatogenesis takes place in the male gonad called as testis. So it takes place in the male gonad testis. The whole process of spermatogenesis, the whole process of spermatogenesis has three stages. The three stages of spermatogenesis are, first one is spermatid formation. Spermatid formation. Second one is spermiogenesis. Spermiogenesis. And final step, spermiation. So these are the three stages of the whole process of spermatogenesis. They are spermatid formation, spermiogenesis, and spermiation. And here the first step, spermatid formation. The spermatid formation have three phases. They are multiplication phase. First one is multiplication phase. Then a growth phase. Growth phase and a maturation phase. Maturation phase. These are the three phases in the process of spermatid formation. So the whole process of spermatogenesis have three stages. They are spermatid formation, spermiogenesis, and spermiation. And the first is spermatid formation have three phases. They are multiplication phase, growth phase, and maturation phase. So, which are the three stages of spermatogenesis? They are spermatid formation, spermiogenesis, and spermiation. The first step is spermatid formation. The process of spermatid formation have three phases. Three phases in spermatid formation, they are multiplication phase. Multiplication phase. Growth phase. And a maturation phase. These are the three phases in the first step of spermatogenesis called as spermatid formation. So the first step of spermatogenesis is spermatid formation. It has three phases. They are multiplication phase, growth phase, and maturation phase. First one is multiplication phase. See, here we know spermatogenesis takes place in the lumen of seminiferous tubules of testis. We know about seminiferous tubule. Suppose this one is a seminiferous tubule. Seminiferous tubule. This one, the wall of seminiferous tubule. Seminiferous tubule. Structural and functional unit of testis. In the lumen of seminiferous tubule, this spermatogenesis takes place. This process of spermatogenesis takes place in the lumen of seminiferous tubule. See, this is the lumen of seminiferous tubule. This lumen of seminiferous tubules are internally lined by the germinal epithelium. So these are the germinal epithelial cells. The germinal epithelial cells include Sertoli cells. The largest cells are Sertoli cells. And the small and numerous cells in the germinal epithelium are spermatogonial cells. So these cells are called as spermatogonium. Spermatogonial cells or the male germ cell. So this is the lumen of seminiferous tubule. This lumen is lined by germinal epithelium formed of Sertoli cell as well as the spermatogonial cells. Here this spermatogenesis takes place in the lumen of this seminiferous tubule. Spermatogenesis takes place here in the lumen of this seminiferous tubule. See, here the first step is spermatid formation. The first phase in spermatid formation is multiplication phase. See, these are spermatogonial cells. See here, at puberty, under the stimulation of androgen, this spermatogonial cell differentiated to form sperm or spermatozoa. And here, the first step in spermatogenesis is this multiplication phase. That means under the stimulation of this androgen, from here, these spermatogonial cells undergo repeated mitosis. These spermatogonial cells undergo repeated mitosis, causes the multiplication of this spermatogonial cell. What happened? Under the stimulation of androgen, these cells start division. And these cells undergo mitosis and causes the multiplication of this spermatogonial cell. That means these are nothing but the copies of this spermatogonial cell. So copies of this spermatogonial cell formed. This phase is known as multiplication phase. So this one is a spermatogonium. And these fundamental spermatogonium, these are the stem cells for the sperm formation. And here these spermatogonial cells undergo repeated mitosis. These spermatogonial cells undergo repeated mitosis. What happened? This causes the multiplication or the copies of these spermatogonial cells formed. This phase is known as multiplication phase. So this is the multiplication phase. Copies of this spermatogonial cell takes place by repeated mitosis is known as multiplication phase. So all these cells formed are spermatogonium. All these cells formed are spermatogonium because these are the copies of this fundamental spermatogonium. So this is the first phase, multiplication phase. The spermatogonial cells undergo repeated mitosis, causes the multiplication of spermatogonium, is the multiplication phase in this spermatid formation. And here, this spermatogonial cell, these are the fundamental cell or the stem cells for sperm production. And these spermatogonial cells are actually formed from the primordial germ cells. The spermatogonial cells are formed from the primordial germ cells of yolk sac in embryonic stage. Next phase is known as growth phase. Second phase is growth phase. See here, during this growth phase, here millions of spermatogonial cells formed by mitosis. And second phase is growth phase, means during this growth phase, each of these spermatogonial cells undergo growth. Each of these spermatogonial cells undergo growth by acquiring nutrients from the surrounding cells like Sertoli cells. Each of these spermatogonial cells undergo growth. So after multiplication, millions of spermatogonium formed. Then this is followed by growth phase. And by acquiring nutrients and by synthesizing new cytoplasmic material, growth of this spermatogonial cell takes place. So each of these spermatogonial cells undergo growth. Each of these spermatogonial cells undergo growth. So as a result of growth, each of these spermatogonial cells acquiring nutrients from the surrounding cell and become the primary spermatocyte. primary spermatocyte. These primary spermatocytes are nothing but spermatogonium. These spermatogonial cells undergo growth by acquiring nutrients. There is no change in the nuclear material of this spermatogonium. By acquiring nutrients and by synthesizing new cytoplasmic material, the size of this spermatogonium increases. After the growth, these spermatogonial cells are called as primary spermatocyte. So after the growth, these spermatogonial cells are called as primary spermatocyte. So this growth phase means growth of each of the spermatogonial cell takes place. That means one spermatogonium gives rise to one primary spermatocyte. And here four spermatogonial cells are there. These four primary spermatogonium undergo growth to form four primary spermatocyte. If millions of spermatogonium formed, what happened? Millions of primary spermatocyte formed in the seminiferous tubule of testis. So this is growth phase. What is growth phase? Growth of each of these spermatogonial cell by acquiring nutrients and form the primary spermatocyte. As a result, one spermatogonium gives rise to one primary spermatocyte. So as like spermatogonium, this primary spermatocyte also a diploid cell. This primary spermatocyte also have 46 chromosomes in humans. Next phase is maturation phase. Maturation phase means here the meiosis or the reduction division takes place during this maturation phase. So here, this is the primary spermatocyte. It's a diploid cell. This diploid primary spermatocyte undergo first meiosis. This diploid primary spermatocyte undergo first meiosis to form two haploid cells. The diploid primary spermatocyte undergo first meiosis to form two haploid cells. These two haploid cells are called as secondary spermatocytes. Secondary spermatocyte. This primary spermatocyte undergo first meiosis to form two haploid secondary spermatocyte. That means here, these secondary spermatocytes are formed in the lumen of seminiferous tubule. Secondary spermatocytes are formed in the lumen of seminiferous tubule as a result of the first meiosis. Only first meiosis completed here, only first meiosis. This is followed by a second meiosis. That means these two haploid secondary spermatocytes, these two haploid secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiosis. These two cells undergo second meiosis. So these two cells undergo second meiosis. As a result, from a secondary spermatocyte, this secondary spermatocyte undergoes second meiosis to form two haploid cell. As a result, from these two secondary spermatocyte, these two secondary spermatocyte undergo second meiosis to form four haploid cells. So these two secondary spermatocytes undergo second meiosis to form four haploid cell. These haploid cells are called as spermatids. These haploid cells are called as spermatids. This is the first stage in spermatogenesis. Spermatid formation, the formation of this spermatid. This spermatid formation have three phases. First one is multiplication phase. Multiplication of the spermatogonial cell by mitosis. Second is growth phase. Growth of each spermatogonial cell takes place. Third is maturation phase. This formed primary spermatocyte by growth. Undergo first and second meiosis to form four haploid secondary four haploid spermatids. So how many spermatids formed from a secondary spermatocyte? One secondary spermatocyte gives rise to two spermatids.
two secondary spermatocytes give rise to four spermatids. This is first step, spermatic formation. Then, you know, spermatogenesis have three stages. First is spermatid formation. Second one is spermiogenesis. Second step is spermiogenesis. So, second step of spermatogenesis is spermiogenesis. See, spermiogenesis means here we got spermatids. The haploid spermatids are formed in the lumen of seminiferous tubule. The haploid spermatids are formed. Suppose this one is a spermatid. This is a spermatid. Spermatid is a haploid cell. Haploid cell means it have a haploid nucleus and cytoplasm. The cytoplasm contain all the cellular organelles like Golgi body, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex. All the cell organelles are there. Here, a number of changes takes place in this spermatid. A number of changes takes place in this spermatid, and some changes include. First one. This spermatid undergo condensation. Cell condensation takes place in spermatid. Cell condensation takes place. So cell condensation takes place in the spermatid. First step is cell condensation. This is followed by a cap-like structure formed from the Golgi body. A cap-like structure formed from the Golgi bodies of this spermatid. A cap-like structure. That is, this cap-like structure is nothing but the modified Golgi body. A cap-like structure formed from the Golgi body with a number of proteins or enzymes inside this cap-like structure. And a cap-like structure formed from the Golgi body called as acrosome. A cap-like acrosome formed from the Golgi body. So the spermatid undergo condensation. First change is cell condensation takes place. Then a cap-like acrosome formed in this spermatid from the Golgi body. This is followed by the multiplication of mitochondria. The cell organelle mitochondria undergo multiplication in this spermatid. Mitochondrial multiplication takes place in the spermatid. And followed by a long tail. A ciliar flagella, a long tail or flagella arises from the centriole of this spermatid. So other change is a tail formation. A tail formation from the centriole of this spermatid. See, as a result of this change, now this spermatid undergo metamorphosis. A lot of changes in spermatid which resulted in the formation of sperm or spermatozoa. That stage is known as spermiogenesis. So spermiogenesis means formation of sperm from spermatids. Formation of sperm from spermatid called as spermiogenesis. So this is the second step. Spermiogenesis means formation of this sperm or spermatozoa from the spermatid called as spermiogenesis. And what are the changes during this spermiogenesis? The changes during this spermiogenesis are cell condensation in this spermatid, acrosome formation, multiplication of mitochondria,
and a long tail formation, etc.
are the changes occurs in spermatid.
By these changes, the spermatid become a haploid spermatozoa. This stage is known as spermiogenesis. Okay, so spermiogenesis means formation of sperm. So spermiogenesis means formation of sperm from the spermatid. This is the second step of spermiogenesis. So how many sperm formed from a spermatid? One spermatid give rise to one sperm. Okay, one spermatid give rise to one sperm. So here four spermatids are formed. Four spermatid give rise to four sperm. Then how many sperm from a secondary spermatocyte? One secondary spermatocyte give rise to two sperm. Two secondary spermatocyte give rise to four sperm. Then how many sperm from a primary spermatocyte? One primary spermatocyte give rise to two secondary spermatocyte. As a result, one primary spermatocyte give rise to four sperm. Then how many sperm from a spermatogonium? One spermatogonium give rise to one primary spermatocyte. We know from one primary spermatocyte, four sperm were formed. That means one spermatogonium give rise to four sperm. One spermatogonium give rise to four sperm. Okay. So here this spermatid formation as well as spermiogenesis takes place in the lumen of seminiferous tubule. And after the formation of sperm, this sperm get buried in Sertoli cells. After the formation, this sperm get buried in Sertoli cells. So after the formation, the sperm get buried in Sertoli cell for getting nourishment or nutrient from this Sertoli cell. Suppose this is a testis and this one is seminiferous tubule. We know seminiferous tubule opens into a duct called as rete testis. This rete testis opens to another duct, vasa efferentia. We already learned about this structure, this duct system, vasa efferentia. This vasa efferentia leads to a long duct called as this vasa efferentia leads to a long duct called epididymis. This epididymis leads to another duct, vas deferens. These are the ducts of testis, accessory ducts of testis. And here, this is seminiferous tubule. And this is a cross section of this seminiferous tubule. And here, in the lumen of this seminiferous tubule, this spermatogenesis takes place. In the lumen of seminiferous tubule, spermatogenesis takes place. See this process. Multiplication phase, growth phase, maturation phase, and spermiogenesis takes place in the lumen of this seminiferous tubule. After the formation of sperm, the sperm get buried in the Sertoli cell for getting nourishment. But this formed sperm cell or spermatozoa are not fully motile. Even after the formation of tail, these cells were not motile. So this formed sperm cells are not motile as well as not matured. This formed spermatozoa are not motile as well as not matured. But we know the ejaculated sperm, the sperm which is deposited to the female genital tract, that ejaculated sperm are usually motile and they are mature also. But this produced sperm in the seminiferous tubules of testis are not motile as well as not matured. So for fertilization, body need a fully matured as well as fully motile sperm. But we know the function of this epididymis. Because when seminiferous tubule release sperm into the rete testis, vasa efferentia and epididymis. That means the sperm released from seminiferous tubule or the sperm in the early part of epididymis are not motile and not matured. This sperm become fully motile and active and fully matured only in the tail of epididymis. The tail of epididymis is called as coda epididymis. Sperm become fully motile, fully matured and fully active only in the coda region of epididymis. When sperm reaches this coda region, this sperm will become fully matured. So the sperm released from the seminiferous tubule as well as the sperm in the early stage of epididymis are not matured as well as not motile. Sperm become fully motile and active only in this coda region or the tail region of epididymis. So for maturation, this formed sperm in the seminiferous tubule, we know sperm formed in the seminiferous tubule, after the formation they get buried in Sertoli cell. So next, for fertilization, body need a matured or motile sperm. So for the maturation, the sperm formed in the seminiferous tubules are released to this accessory duct. This step is known as spermiation. The third stage in spermatogenesis is spermiation, means for the maturation of sperm. Sperm from the seminiferous tubule or the sperm released from the Sertoli cells of seminiferous tubules are called as spermiation. So for the maturation, we know after the formation, sperm get buried in Sertoli cell. So for the maturation, sperm cells are released from the Sertoli cells of seminiferous tubule. Sperm cells are released from the Sertoli cells of seminiferous tubule to this accessory duct for the maturation. This process is known as spermiation. So what is spermiation? The process of releasing your sperm from the Sertoli cells of seminiferous tubules are called as spermiation. And this spermiation for the maturation of sperm within the epididymis. That means the sperm become fully motile and active only in the epididymis of sperm. Not within the lumen of seminiferous tubule. And from the epididymis, these sperm cells get stored in this vas deferens. So during ejaculation, sperm cells are released from the vas deferens. This stored sperm from vas deferens are ejaculated during coitus or during ejaculation. The sperm stored in the vas deferens are released, not from the testis, because the mature as well as the fully motile sperm are found in epididymis as well as this vas deferens. So this form the spermatogenesis for the formation of sperm. Next part is the structure of spermatozoa or sperm. Structure of sperm. A typical human sperm have four distinct regions. They are a head portion, then a neck portion, a middle piece, and a tail region. These are the four distinct regions of human sperm: head, neck, middle piece, and tail. And here, first one is head. This head comprises a cap-like portion. This cap-like part of head is called as acrosome. So head comprises a cap-like acrosome and a condensed nucleus. A condensed nucleus as well as acrosome seen on the head portion of sperm. So head comprises this acrosome and nucleus, comprises head. And here, this is acrosome. And it is a modified Golgi complex. Inside this acrosome contain a group of enzymes. Inside the acrosome contain a group of enzymes called as sperm lysine. Inside this acrosome contain a group of enzymes. This group of enzymes called as sperm lysine. And this sperm lysine includes hyaluronidase and
proteases. These are the sperm lysin or the enzymes of acrosome. So the acrosomal enzymes are hyaluronidase as well as proteases. And its function. This acrosomal enzyme helps in fertilization. And how this enzyme helps in fertilization? Suppose this is human egg. And in this human egg, it has a haploid nucleus and cytoplasm. Then egg envelopes include a protein membrane. This protein membrane called as zona pellucida. We'll study in later. The egg envelope, zona pellucida, is a protein membrane. Followed by an outer membrane. This outer covering is corona radiata. Anyway, this envelope we'll study in later. This corona radiata, zona pellucida, these are the egg covering or egg envelopes. And here, the zona pellucida is a protein membrane. And this corona radiata, here these cells of this outer membrane, these are the different types of cells. These are the modified granulosa cells of ovary. Anyway, we'll discuss it later. These corona radiata cells, these cells are very firmly adhered to the egg surface. Or these envelopes are very firmly attached to the egg envelope with the help of a cementing material called as hyaluronic acid. This hyaluronic acid is the cementing material which firmly adheres these envelopes to the egg surface. And it is a proteoglycan. This hyaluronic acid is a proteoglycan. So when suppose this is the acrosome of sperm. When the acrosome of the sperm touch the egg envelope, what happened? This acrosomal membrane ruptured. As a result, the sperm lysin releases to the egg envelope. The sperm lysin, this enzyme, like a hyaluronidase and proteases, the sperm lysin releases to the egg envelope. And the enzymes of this sperm lysin dissolves this egg envelope. Enzymes of this sperm lysin dissolves the egg envelope. So, thereby facilitated path for sperm entry. Through this path, the sperm nucleus enters the egg cytoplasm. So, what is the role of the sperm lysin? The sperm lysin contains a group of enzymes. These enzymes of sperm lysin dissolves the egg envelopes, facilitate fertilization. This is the role of sperm lysin. Next part is neck. This is the neck region. This neck is a small constricted region. It's a constricted region between this head and middle piece. This constricted region between the head and middle piece called as neck. And here this neck contains two centrioles. Two centrioles are seen in this neck. So this neck contains two centrioles. They are a proximal centriole and a distal centriole in the neck. And here this distal centriole, you know, sperm is a flagellated cell. Its movement requires the flagella or tail or the tail. But the beating or the movement of this tail with the help of a cytoskeleton. Since this is that cytoskeleton of spermatozoa. This central cytoskeleton. This cytoskeleton contains about 11 microtubules. These 11 microtubules bundled as a skeleton in this spermatozoa called as axoneme. Axonem. So this axonem is a 11 microtubule bundle. It's a cytoskeleton which facilitates the movement of spermatozoa. Anyway, this cytoskeleton or this axoneme or this axial skeleton arises from this distal centriole. But one more centriole, a proximal centriole. This proximal centriole function. See,
This is human ovum. In this ovum stage, or in this oocyte, this ovum or in this oocyte stage, functional centrioles are absent in this ovum. Centrioles are not functional in this ovum or oocyte. But during fertilization, we know the sperm nucleus releases to the egg cytoplasm, followed by fusion of these two nucleus form a diploid zygote. See, suppose this is a zygote, and here in this zygote, the paternal contribution, the contribution of sperm, is this haploid nucleus. Then the remaining haploid nucleus as well as the cytoplasm provided by this ovum. So what is actually this zygote? This zygote is nothing but ovum. The fertilized ovum is known as zygote. That means this sperm stimulate the egg to start development. And during fertilization, only sperm nucleus releases to the egg cytoplasm, and this egg will become zygote. And after the formation of this zygote start division. It undergo cleavage. Cleavage or division. As a result, become two-celled embryo. Then it become four-celled embryo and will become the multicellular embryo like morula. But we know the animal cell division requires centriole. Such a functional centriole are absent in this ovum. Then how this ovum or egg divide after fertilization? Here is the role of this proximal centriole. That is during fertilization, not only nucleus. During fertilization, sperm nucleus as well as this proximal centriole releases to the egg cytoplasm. So this proximal centriole releases to the egg cytoplasm during fertilization. And from this proximal centriole, the spindle fibers arises and start cleavage or division of the zygote. So its function, it facilitates the division of zygote or cleavage after fertilization. So during fertilization, this proximal centriole contributed to the egg cytoplasm and facilitated cleavage. This is the role of proximal centriole. These are the two centrioles of the neck. Next is the middle piece. This middle piece contains this central cytoskeleton called as axoneme, the central cytoskeleton formed of 11 microtubules. So this middle piece contains this cytoskeleton axoneme. And in addition to this cytoskeleton, a number of mitochondria are also here. These are mitochondria. But this central axial filament is helically wound by this mitochondria. So this middle piece contains mitochondrial spiral. The spirally arranged mitochondriums are also found in this middle piece. And this mitochondria for providing energy to the spermatozoa. So this middle piece contains this axoneme as well as this mitochondrial spiral. Next is the long tail. This tail facilitates the movement of sperm. And here only this axoneme or this cytoskeleton extended to the tail. Only the cytoskeleton extended to the tail. And this tail facilitates the movement of spermatozoa. This form the structure of sperm. So typical human sperm have four distinct regions: head, neck, middle piece and tail. Head contain acrosome and nucleus. Then neck contain a proximal and distal centriole. Middle piece contain the axial filament as well as the mitochondrial spiral. And tail contain only this axoneme of the cytoskeleton. This form the structure of spermatozoa. So these sperms are formed from spermatogonium. The changes from spermatogonium to sperm. The changes from spermatogonium to sperm takes about 74 days. So about 74 days required for the formation of sperm from this spermatogonium. And if sperm deposited to a female reproductive tract, then after ejaculation, within the female reproductive tract, the sperms are viable up to 48 hours. So this Next is the hormonal regulation male reproductive system, hormonal regulation. So the hormonal regulation in human male reproductive system. We know the supreme commando of our endocrine system is hypothalamus. Supreme commando of our endocrine system. And this hypothalamus contains some neurosecretory cells. These neurosecretory cells of hypothalamus secrete several neurohormones or releasing hormones. See here, this hypothalamus secrete. This hypothalamus secrete a releasing hormone called as GnRH. Gonadotropin releasing hormone, hypothalamus secrete releasing hormone called GnRH. So this hypothalamus secrete GnRH, gonadotropin releasing hormone. And this GnRH act on the adenohypophysis or the anterior pituitary gland, in the anterior lobe of pituitary gland. But we know the anterior pituitary gland contains several cells, several different types of cells are there. And here the GnRH act on a cell called as, GnRH act on a cell called gonadotropes of this anterior pituitary gland. So hypothalamus secrete GnRH, this GnRH stimulate the gonadotropes. Gonadotrope is a cell. This gonadotropes of adenohypophysis or anterior pituitary gland. Gonadotropes of anterior pituitary gland. Then this gonadotrope secrete. Then this cell secrete, this gonadotropes, this cell secrete gonadotropins. Under the stimulation of this GnRH, this gonadotrope secrete gonadotropins. These gonadotropins are FSH and LH. Both of these FSH as well as LH, these two hormones act on the gonad called as testis. And here, FSH function. FSH stimulate Sertoli cells of testis. FSH stimulate Sertoli cells of testis. As a result, this Sertoli cells secrete androgen binding protein. We already studied about this protein, androgen binding protein. What is the role of this androgen binding protein? This androgen binding protein, ABP, concentrate androgen in testis. This ABP concentrate androgen in testis. By concentrating androgen in testis, this ABP enhances, thereby it stimulates spermatogenesis. Because we know spermatogenesis required the hormone androgen. By concentrating androgen in testis, this ABP enhances spermatogenesis. By concentrating androgen in testis. Then this Sertoli cells secrete growth signal or growth factors, means these are some paracrine signal. And this Sertoli cell, under the stimulation of FSH, this Sertoli cell produce some growth factors required for spermiogenesis. Growth factors required for spermiogenesis. Then, this Sertoli cell, under the stimulation of FSH, this Sertoli cell secrete small amount of estrogen in male. It secretes small amount of estrogen, and this estrogen also helps in this spermiogenesis, but only very small amount of estrogen from this Sertoli cell under the stimulation of FSH. So these are the role of FSH in male. While LH, we know testis contain seminiferous tubule, and between the seminiferous tubule, the cells are called as interstitial cell. Interstitial cells or Leydig cell. So LH stimulate
this interstitial cell. Let's stimulate interstitial cells or Leydig cells. Let's stimulate interstitial cells or Leydig cells for secreting androgens. For secreting androgens. So let's stimulate these interstitial cells or Leydig cells for secreting androgen. So hence this LH is called as ICSH. Because what is its function? It stimulates interstitial cell. So in human male, LH acts as interstitial cell stimulating hormone. ICSH, interstitial cell stimulating hormone. This is the role of LH in male. So let's stimulate the interstitial cell for secreting androgen. And this androgen plays a vital role in human male reproductive system. And the role of androgen in human male reproductive system includes: androgen helps in the descent of testes. We know in embryonic state, testes are formed in abdominal cavity. But the descent of testes into scrotum with the help of androgen. So androgen causes the descent of testes into scrotum. Then helps in the development of secondary sex organs. Helps in the development of secondary sex organs like accessory sex gland, the penis or external genitalia. The development required this androgen. So androgen causes the development of secondary sex organs. Then it controls the secondary sexual characters. The hormone androgen is needed for the development of secondary sexual characters. This androgen controls the male sexual behavior or the libido. It controls the male sexual behavior or libido by act on central nervous system. It controls the male sexual behavior. Then this androgen causes masculinization. This androgen is responsible for masculinization or the male-like feature by the action of this androgen. Then it stimulates erythropoiesis in male. It stimulates erythropoiesis or RBC production. It increases RBC production. It stimulates erythropoiesis in male. Then this androgen is an anabolic steroid. This androgen is an anabolic steroid because it enhances the anabolism of proteins in muscle. It enhances the anabolism of proteins in muscle. So it is an anabolic steroid. This is why some athletes are misused with this anabolic steroid like androgen for increasing their athletic performance. Because this androgen is an anabolic steroid. It increases the metabolism of androgen in muscle. Thereby, it causes the development of muscle and muscular system. So it causes the strengthening of muscle also. This androgen is an anabolic steroid. Then it causes the change in voice pitch. It causes the change in voice pitch. Because at puberty, by the action of androgen, the vocal cord become enlarged. That enlarged vocal cord causes, or the enlarged larynx causes the change in voice pitch. And this androgen causes the facial body, pubic, chest, above umbilical region, above umbilical hair development. So it causes pubic, axial and facial hair development in body. It causes pubic hair development, axial hair development, then above the umbilical region, in the chest region. All this hair development is induced by this androgen. But this androgen inhibits the development of hair on the top of head. This androgen inhibits the development of hair on the top of head. That means a man who does not have a functional testis does not become bald. Because it causes baldness. This androgen causes baldness by inhibiting the growth of hair on the top of head. So it causes baldness in him. Then this androgen causes spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis is under the control of this androgen. This androgen causes the spermatogenesis. So these are some functions of androgen. Okay. So in this session, we completed the spermatogenesis, means formation of sperm, then structure of spermatozoa, and hormonal regulation human male reproductive system.
Okay guys, thank you for watching my videos. Please like, share and subscribe my channel, Sharon Zoology. Bye.